Mm-hmm. I've been expecting you YouTubers to be here. Now it's time to exact my plan. Which is, what is up YouTubers? Jonty here. Welcome back to some more Minecraft Story Mode. So last time, we are in Hadrian's office, apparently. And yeah, we've looked pretty much at everything. Except for Tim's armor. So we're going to be looking at that. I also noticed something also. On the right side of my inventory, my sword is gone. I'm sad. Anyway, so let's look at the armor. Tim's armor. let's just look. I don't want to get in too much trouble.
Hey, that's that Tim guy's armor.
I would love that armor, but...
Welcome, Jesse.
Oh, hi.
Fantastic to have you here. Just fantastic. Thanks for accepting my invitation. Seems appropriate that you gravitate toward Tim's armor. What with everyone calling you the new Tim down there? Yes, I've heard the rumors that they're calling you that, and I can definitely see why. People love an underdog story. It's quite the little journey.
Give it to me straight. Why did you invite me up here, Hayden?
Why, so we could continue to discuss the terms of our deal.
More terms?
You could look closer. Go ahead. I assume by now you've heard all about Tim.
Oh, yeah.
Repeatedly.
Everyone loves him. And why shouldn't they? After all, he's Tim.
Yeah, it seems like he really gives them hope.
Even better than that, they really believe in him. Tim is an inspiration to them, even when he's not here. One could say he's an inspiration because he's not here.
What do you mean?
It's so much easier for a legend to stay nice and shiny when it's a fond memory. Easier to control. I've been watching your legend grow, but I worry that with you still in the picture, it could get messy. I've been starting to think it would be best if you made a quiet exit. You don't belong here. These games aren't for you.
Well, that doesn't sound like the deal we made. You trying to change our terms?
Think of this as a shiny new deal. See, there's something you should know about the games. No one ever wins unless we want them to. Not even Tim. Let that sink in for a moment, eh?
I'm not buying it, Hadrian. Is Tim even real?
I knew you were a smart one, bucko.
How dare you.
He's not real. Tim gives them hope. He keeps them playing the games, but no one wins. Ever. Which is why I think it'd be in your best interest to play along. But don't you miss your friends? Your treehouse?
Wait. My treehouse?
The Atlas can see where people are from now. So I had Mevia go check it out. Turns out you're pretty famous. I was impressed. Had to bring back some things you might be interested in.
Axel! Olivia!
Oh, hi, guys.
Oh my gosh, I can't believe you're here.
Yeah, this really scary lady showed up and knocked us out. Now we're in these smelly boxes.
What's going on here?
That guy's voice is the worst. I can even hear it through the obsidian.
Not gonna lie, guys, it's bad. We're in a world where everyone is forced to compete in these crazy games and will be prisoners forever if I don't win.
That is bad.
I'm so sorry you guys got roped into this.
Yeah, that's not the best.
Wait until I tell the others you're here. I've missed you guys so much.
Wow. This is just, wow. Such a tapestry of human trauma and emotion. And we haven't even gotten to the best part. I saved that for last.
What?
Oh, yes. Your best friend. Reuben.
Reuben? Oh.
So, I've heard all about him. Your best friend. Your partner in crime.
Hi, Reuben.
Oh,
Nothing too much. How about yourself?
Oh, same.
This is so awkward.
I know.
You used the Atlas to kidnap all my best friends. Why?
Yeah, it's set up, Jesse. It's set up. See, even if you win, and that's a mighty big if, let your friends go? All of them? You'll just have to stay behind in their place. I hear it's terrible in those lives. But aren't your friends worth it?
If you're this scared of me, I must have a better shot of winning than you're letting on.
Or maybe I'm just tired of a little pipsqueak interfering with my games. Okay, I had hoped that watching your sad reunion would be entertaining, but I'm done now. You say sport, your freedom for theirs, huh? Do you think you're worth more than all of them? Do you even really think you can win these games?
Wow, tough one. That's actually kind of a good deal.
Yeah, except the part where Jesse would be stuck here forever.
No way, Adrian. I don't make deals with cheaters.
Fine. Play it your way. Which is to say, I will crush you. And you won't win anyway. Slap! Get this garbage out of my office.
Sure thing, boss. Come on, idiot.
No! Well, ain't that just great? The most dangerous games. He's playing with fire now. I mean, it'd be pure evil if he trapped Reuben. Like, the actual Reuben. You know, when I actually saw the 8th episode of my first playthrough, when he mentioned Reuben, I was like, wait, is Reuben actually back? Run, Jesse. Yep. And his knees.
What?
He used the Atlas to snatch them from our world.
No.
Are they okay?
Other than Adrian having them trapped in obsidian prisons. But he offered me the deal. He said he'll send you all home if I lose and go to the mines in your place. I didn't take the deal.
Oh. Guess that was probably the right move.
Probably. What? You thought that deal sounded good? I don't trust Adrian. No way was I going to take any shady deal from him.
You're right. You're probably right.
And that's why I didn't
Jesse
take the deal.
Smart. Adrian never would have kept that deal. Even if you did volunteer to throw the game, he'd just send you all to the mines anyway. Probably. While claiming that was the original deal. So who's supposed to help us then? Adrian and Nevia are both clearly the worst.
But what about the third guy?
Otto? How could he help? He's always stayed out of the more lever-pulling sides of the games.
He seems like a big fan of the rules. Maybe we can use that to our advantage.
Huh. He loves rules, that's for sure. Always plays by them. If you won, I know he would definitely make sure you got that Atlas. That was the original deal, and he's an honorable man.
Harper, Adrian still has my friends trapped in that obsidian prison. I can win the Atlas, but I'm going to need you to get them out.
I can handle it.
Good. There's three of them. They're in Adrian's office.
Wait. You really think you can free everyone in this place and win the games?
Yeah.
In line with that last part, do you really think you can just beat all the other teams by yourself? That is a pretty tall order. Even for you, Jesse. Oh, it's impossible is what it is.
The old builders expect us all to fight each other. I don't intend to give them the satisfaction.
You're what? Gonna convince everyone to work together?
Oh, yeah.
Whoa. Looks like we've got a little bit of an audience here.
Hello.
Whisper.
I think it's your cue to do your thing.
Right. Here we go.
Tomorrow, if we work together, we can all win together.
But Jesse, you're not on my team. See, my jumpsuit is yellow.
Builders want you to think. Adrian keeps twisting and changing the rules. I say it's our time to change the rules on them.
What's the point? Adrian will still have all the power. There's no way he's gonna let us just take that from him. He'll just make up some new rule. It's useless.
Don't you want to go home, Em?
I do. More than anything. But nobody beats Hadrian at his own games. Nobody.
Hey! Tim did!
You're right, he did. You gotta keep those spirits up.
A long time ago. That's right. Tim did beat the games, and so can we.
Yeah, sure. Except nobody's been able to do it since Tim. So what's the point? And it's not like I haven't been trying. We all have.
Someday, someone else is gonna win. They're gonna say that person was the first winner since Tim. Don't you want that person to be you?
I mean, yeah, of course. But what chance do we stand against those gladiators? The stories didn't exactly say what Tim did to beat them.
Yeah. I mean, well, it's like an inspiring idea and all that, but those gladiators are, like, super tough. And I don't know how Tim pulled off beating them, but okay, look, for real, I don't think I could do that. Like, max level scariness, okay? Boo! Oh, no, I mean totally OP.
I'm not sure how Tim pulled off defeating the gladiators. Fists are huge, your weapons are super scary.
Where's Jesse going with this?
You know what I am sure of? If we combine all our fists and stuff, we're gonna be even tougher than the gladiators.
Now give me a diamond sword.
I get it now.
If we work together as a team.
Raise hands in the air. Thank you, Ivor. Hopefully everybody will remember that. Okay.
Look, I think I did a good job. But strength doesn't come from speeches. Actions speak louder than words. Can't expect you to just talk your way through this, Jesse.
Strength comes from believing in yourself, Em.
Sounds like a bunch of nonsense, Jesse. Sorry.
Man, so crowd. Think they got through to him?
Wait, so who are we fighting then?
Action definitely seemed mixed.
Yeah, no kidding.
A lot of diehard Tim fans.
It had to, or else we're in big trouble.
Yeah, that last game is all or nothing.
True.
Well, I guess we'll find out for sure in the morning.
And with that said and done, we're gonna end this video here, so we will see if we can win the games in the next video. So thank you guys so much for watching this video. If you like this video, press the like button or subscribe, do whatever. And I'll see all you dudes in the next video. See you dudes next time.